It's playing. Lots of people have said, why don't you play it? Well, it's playing. It does work, it does play, it sounds beautiful. I don't know what you're going to hear on your whatever device you're listening to it on, but anyway, I thought I'd do it. I'm going to do a record review today again. I've got 10 albums that I want to tell you about, and I think they sound really good. They do on my system anyway. And there's two duds that I'm going to flag up as well. Pretty irrelevant really, but it's just a bit more fun. Okay, so let's start off first of all with a dud. This is a disappointing dud. This is Marillion. I love their music. They're very much like Genesis, and I've always been fond of Genesis in the past, but Marillion. And the album is called Clutching at Straws. It's got some really good tracks on it. Incommunicado, Hotel Hobbies, I don't know, whatever. Can't remember because I don't play it very often. But it's a nice album. Clutching at Straws, but it is, in my view, it is just a poor recording. I've classified this, I use a classification 0 to 10 for all my albums on my database, and I've classified this album as 5. That's all. Actually, where's my list? Won't be a minute, I'm coming back. Just forgot the bloody list, here we go. Right, here's my list. Yeah, so it's 5. Yeah, 5, that's all I've got. 5 is all I can classify this for, so it's just a shame. Why can't we produce records which all have a general high quality sound too? Why do they have to vary so much? I mean, some records are quiet, some you have to turn the volume up miles to get them to play at a reasonable level. They got pops and crackles on, even new records you buy today, some are terrible. I don't know, they need to get their quality control sorted out. And they need a standard. We need a standard for vinyl. It's getting popular now, so they say. So let's have a standard where every record you can listen to at the same volume, and it's got a dynamic range to it and a good quality. They'd sell more records, wouldn't they, for Christ's sake? Sorry, get that off my soapbox. So there's one, a dud. That's a dud. So now, let's start looking at records that I recommend. I mean, this is a record that many of you will be familiar with, I'm sure. David Bowie. And it's called Let's Dance. And the interesting thing about this is, guess who is the mastering engineer on it? Bob Ludwig. Bob Ludwig crops up a lot in the videos that I've done so far, and also most of my records, a lot of my records that I really think are well recorded, he's normally involved in somewhere, or Greg Calby. There's a list of mastering engineers that are renowned for their quality and their skill. Yeah, so this is a great album. David Bowie, highly recommended. I've classified this as, let me see, can't find it. David Bowie, where's David Bowie on here? Oh, David Bowie, 9. I'll give it 9. Okay, so that's David Bowie. Actually, I better take this record off. Don't want to be wearing out the needle, do we? Okay, number two. Again, a record that anybody that knows anything about hi-fi is probably going to have heard of this. It's Donald Fagen, and it's called Night Flight. Donald Fagen, if you don't know, was a member of Steely Dan. And this is one of his solo albums. He's done a number of solo albums, and they're all very good quality. This is lovely. And again, my favourite tracks on this one is probably Walk Between Raindrops and Maxine, Ruby Baby. They're all good tracks. I don't know who's the mastering engineer on this. I should have researched this really. It looks like it's Bob Ludwig at Master Disc. God, Bob, you do get about. You must spend all your time sat at mastering things, machines, whatever they are. Good album, that is. Donald Fagen, The Nightfly. Now, here's a record which I have to say, I didn't realise after valuing this record how much it's worth. I was quite shocked. It's worth possibly a couple hundred quid, £200. And it's Electric Light Orchestra, and it's called Zoom. And it's a modern reissue. It's Let Them Eat Vinyl. It was issued in, I don't know when, probably 2013, or was that, yeah, probably, possibly, don't know. Anyway, it's the ELO Zoom. Got some great, great tracks on it, and it sounds incredible for a modern production, so to speak. A modern reissue, really, isn't it? I don't know. Is it or no? I don't know. Anyway, it's clear vinyl, which is nice. Not that I'm that bothered. I don't think I can tell you anything more about it because I don't think I can find it quick enough, and it's going to waste time. But anyway, highly recommended. This one, I classify this at 10. Now, I've only got a couple of handfuls, maybe 10 or 15 records that I classify as 10. This is one of them, Zoom, ELO. Another one, of course, would be Dark Side of the Moon. So it sounds very, very good. It's the sort of record you put on and you don't want to move away. You just want to sit there and listen to it. You can't go and do anything. You can't wash up. You can't go and sit down and read the paper or anything. You just got to focus your ears on this beautiful sound that's coming out of the speakers. So, yes, very good. Okay, another one then, which is might be a bit of a surprise to some of you. I don't know. It's Casey Musgraves. Casey Musgraves, and it's called The Golden Hour. I didn't expect this to be amazing when I first saw the album cover. I don't even know why I bought it. Somebody must have recommended it to me. But it really is some nice songs on it. She's got a lovely voice, and again, it's very well recorded. Highly recommended. I think it's a great record. That's the back. Don't know if you can see much there really, but it's Casey Musgraves. It's a lovely, nicely produced gatefold sleeve. I can't tell you any particularly good, they're all good tracks on it. Obviously Gold Now is probably one of the best, but they're all nice tracks. So Casey Musgrave, Gold Now. And that one is 9. I'll give it 9. I'll give it 9. Okay, next one. I love this lady, Laura Cantrell. She has got the most delightful voice. Again, this record, I've classified this as possibly 9. It's 9. Lovely gatefold sleeve. Nice picture of her. She's got a delightful voice. She really has. And And most of her albums, I've got a three or four of them, they're all really nice. It's on the Matador label. This album is called Humming by the Flowered Vine, which is a bit of a strange title, but some good tracks in here. California Rose, Old Downtown, and Letters, all nice tracks. Again, highly recommended, Laura Cantrell. And it's called Humming by the Flowered Vine. Next one is, now, Boris Blank. You may know Boris Blank. He is from the band called Yellow, or the duo called Yellow. Their famous album, in my view, is Toy. But he's teamed up here with Malia, who has got the most amazing voice. And this album is superb. It's a bit of electronica in there, but it's also this lovely female vocal of Malia. Highly recommended. Anything to do with Boris Blank and Yellow is going to be pretty good recording, but this is probably one of the best, I'd say, of all that I've heard of involving Boris Blank. So Malia and Boris Blank, and it's called Convergence. And I've classified this one as 9. So this is a 9 out of 10 in terms of the recording and the quality of the recording and the mastering. I'm not in any way classifying these records as far as the music, because everybody's music tastes are different. So this is purely really on the enjoyment of listening to the music as it's meant to be listened to. Okay, next one up. Now this record, I'm sorry, what I just said I'm going to contradict now, because this is not only a well-recorded song, but album, but it's also an amazing music and lyrics. The lyrics are the thing that really, really make this album so, so special. It's by Roger Waters, as with Pink Floyd, and it is this the life we really want? And how meaningful is that at this moment in time, that we have all these issues in the world with climate change and, you know, pandemics and everything else? Is this the life we really want? And I just think it's so appropriate. But it's very well recorded. Everything that Roger Waters does is well recorded. Amused to Death is amazing. I'll review that one day. But the tracks on this, the ones that I love most of all, Is This the Life We Really Want is incredible. Wait for Her is a most beautiful song, with a piano and a guitar in it. Deja Vu, The Last Refugee, is also superb. All the tracks on this record, once you start listening to it, you'll get hooked on. I can guarantee it, if you like Roger Waters and Pink Floyd. This is an amazing album, a must have. And this is only probably 9, is it? Yeah, it's only 9, but you know, it's still very, very good. 9 is bloody good, believe me. Okay, coming to, we're getting down the list a bit now. This is a girl called Rumour. She has got the most incredible voice. This record is so, so good. It's beautiful, that's all I can explain. And it's got a track on here which is so, because this girl is an international star and most people will know of her, but she's got a track on here called Home Thoughts from Abroad. And if you saw one of the videos I did recently, I actually reviewed the album Home Thoughts from Abroad by what's his name? Oh God, I forgot now, my memory's like rubbish. It's Clifford T. Ward. He was born in the town where I live. I've said that before, but he was born in either Stourport or Kidderminster, which is where I live in the UK. And he made a fantastic album called Home Thoughts from the Wood, and she's taken a track and she's covered. So all of the songs on this album are covers of other people's songs. And P.F. Sloan is amazing. It's a beautiful song. It Could Be the First Day. My Cricket, Same Old Tears on new back on a New Background. They're all famous songs by famous artists, except probably for Home Thoughts from Abroad, which is by Clifford T. Ward, and hardly anybody's ever heard of him probably, but anyway, highly recommended. Lovely album, beautiful lady, beautiful voice. Boys Don't Cry, and I've classified that one as 9. Okay, 2 more left. I'm going to do this other one first because now this is Beck and it's called, Christ knows, I can't remember. It doesn't say. Sea Change. Sea Change. Everybody will tell you that this is a well-recorded album. It is a well-recorded album. It's not entirely my kind of music, if I was honest, but I still enjoy listening to it because it's got a lot going on in there with his voice. The lyrics are very good. And it's a nice album. It's a double album as well, so it takes a bit of playing. You have to keep getting up and changing it over all the time. 3 tracks or so on each side, probably. But Morning Phase, it's really good. Highly recommend it. I've probably given this 9. Yeah, I have. Yeah. So 9 for that one too. And then finally, I think the next one is a 10. Yes, we've got 10. This I've classified as 10. Now, this is a digital recording, unfortunately, but it still gets 10. So you can make fantastic albums from digital recordings. You don't have to have, it doesn't have to be analog necessarily. This is still good. Is It So, Cat Stevens. Some fantastic tracks on this. The Old School Yard, Killing Time, Child for a Day, Bonfire, Was Dog a Donut? Don't know what that's about, but it's an amazing album. Lovely gatefold cover, beautiful sound. It's in my, obviously, as it's got classified, I've classified it as 10, so it is in my top list of albums of all time. It was produced in, what if they put things on here that you could actually read? It's the Island Record label. When was it? Don't tell you nothing on it at all. No, it does. 1977. Must have been one of the early digital recordings that were made, I'd imagine. Yeah, anyway, it's a great record. Is It So? Cat Stevens, highly recommended. Get it if you like Cat Stevens. Get it if you don't like Cat Stevens, because you'll like it. Sounds amazing. So that's it. Those are my 10 records for the time being. Hope you enjoyed the review. I'm going to put the record back on again now so that you can listen to it for a short while. I don't quite know what the benefit of this is really, but it's nice. I love my record player and I hope you'll enjoy listening to a little bit of the first track of Freya Riding's album. Again, I reviewed this and it's really good. So enjoy for a few seconds or a minute and then I'll see you again soon. Thanks then, bye. I'm Hang on, don't go away. I forgot to give you the second dud. I said there were two duds I was going to tell you about. I forgot to give you the second one. Quickly then, this one. We all love Pink Floyd and we all love David Gilmour. This album by David Gilmour, About Face, is a brilliant album. It could be amazing, but this copy, I don't know whether it's my copy or what, but it's a classified as a 5 in my reckoning, so I don't know why. It's got some lovely tracks on it. It's got All Lovers Are Deranged, Love on the Air, Until We Sleep, which is a really good track. And it was mastered by Doug Sachs. This is what I don't understand. Doug Sachs is good mastering engineer, but, and this is an original 1984 pressing. It's an original UK pressing, but it's got nothing to it. It's got no dynamics to it at all. So I don't understand why. There's something strange about records that I don't understand, unless it's my ears, but I don't think it is. So this is David Gilmour, About Face. Unless you can get buy it if you wish, by all means. If you haven't got it, get it. But make sure you see if you can find a good first pressing or whatever, because this particular pressing I've got is not very good. It's the number is SHSP 2400791. And it's stereo, yeah. I'm pretty certain this is an original UK first pressing, but not very good. Not very interesting. Sorry, David. Don't like it. Okay, that's me finished now. No more duds, no more records. Not for a while. I'll come back again very, very soon. Take care, everybody. Bye.